There is a lot of doubt about what the role of humanity is going to be in a world dominated by artificial intelligence. How can we thrive if more and more what we define jobs are going to be covered by smarter and smarter computers in our environment, in our workplace, in our lives? This has been the case in the past as well. When technological evolution appeared to displace a lot of human labor, and there has been a period of adaptation following the development of these technologies, change that was painful, also because society didn't support those that needed to adapt. Today is going to be characterized with the progressive spreading of AI in the lives of more and more communities, in more and more economic segments, by a rapid change that will be especially difficult to understand, analyze, and cope with. This rapid change is not going to happen across several generations, but in the next 5-10 years, and it is going to be essential for everybody to be as nimble and adaptable as possible, to embrace new technologies because they are unstoppable. It would be pointless to try and slow them down. In a globally interconnected world, they spread, they overcome barriers, and it is impossible to stop them. Instead, it is possible to experiment. The obstacles and the barriers for adopting these new technologies are practically zero, and everybody can understand and benefit from them if they are seen not as enemies but as allies. Let's take an example: self-driving cars. Even though there are a lot of people who today have a job that consists of driving a car or a truck, the benefit to society of self-driving cars is just going to be overwhelming. And it is relatively easy to recognize that the joint enemy that we have is not represented by smart machines, in this case the self-driving cars, but are represented by the dumb machines. The cars that kill too many people every year. Similarly, in other areas of the economy, progressive automation and the spreading of artificial intelligence is going to replace those repetitive tasks, whether based on human muscle, as it has been the case for some decades already, or based on human cognition, that today is delivered by people, the people who do not like their jobs, who do not feel that they are fulfilled in their aspirations and in their opportunities. So this kind of replacement by smart automation must be welcome, because the result is going to be people who can aspire to do more, to do better, to be more creative, and to leverage the infrastructure that enables them to create more value for themselves, the communities they live in, and to society at large.